2NURFM, a broadcast service of the University of Newcastle.
This week with our Professor of Maths and Science from the University of Newcastle, John O'Connor, we're going to be taking a look at invisibility. And John, is something the Romans that were able to conquer. So was it just a case of, do they do this? They put their shirt over like that and be invisible, or do they do something a little bit more high tech than that?
They didn't quite get that far, but I think we should talk about invisibility first and how you achieve it. And people have seen Harry Potter, have seen him pull over the cloak, he goes invisible. And that is theoretically possible.
There is another way. I see it happen here at work a lot. When there's work to be done, a few certain faces, they always become invisible.
Just disappear, yep. it's theoretically possible. And in fact, it's been achieved slightly. Science has been able to achieve invisibility with light, but only in two dimensions, only in a plane, and only with a single or a narrow range of frequencies. You can't do it. You can't create a Harry Potter, but they can do it by taking a normal material and sort of drilling holes at certain points and having a weird structure, and that interacts with the light so that it actually bends around an object. Now, that's possible for small things like light and, you know, small objects. It's not possible for big things, but it's all around how waves propagate. Now, this is where the Romans came in. They didn't actually try and do it with light. In fact, they probably didn't understand the whole process at all. But trial and error, it's believed they actually developed effectively invisibility for seismic waves, in other words, earthquakes.
So this sort of came into being because they were able to, through this trial and error, we understand, to making the buildings in kind of invisible to the seismic activity, or that's where we're headed.
That's right. So there was a study by a French civil engineering company and the Fresnel Foundation, and Fresnel is actually based, it's an institute in France, which is based on the work of a person who created the foundation of a lot of interference about light and so forth. But this civil engineering company and the Fresnel Institute were experimenting by putting concrete pillars up to 5 meters underground in a certain pattern. And they are able to show by sending acoustic waves in other words, you know, sound waves through the soil, that this would be reflected back. So if this was an earthquake, if there were waves from an earthquake, they would actually be reflected back. And so they worked out this property on a test scale. And then one of the engineers went on holidays and he went to one of the old Roman cities and he was looking at the guidebook and he looked at the pattern of the foundations of the buildings, the amphitheatres and so forth. And he thought, that looks very familiar. And he actually laid it over what they had developed as this project. And sure enough, it was a perfect match. And so no one's suggesting the Romans actually had all the theory mapped out and all the experiments mapped out, but it was very probably by trial and error. But it seems that there's a very strong correlation between the experiment they did and the Roman buildings. And one can imagine that it was, yes, trial and error. In somewhere like Italy, where there are so many earthquakes and so many devastating earthquakes, they'd observe which buildings stayed standing and which ones got knocked over in an earthquake, and they could actually refine the process. And refining that process took them to a case where the building was invisible, in inverted commas. I could sit here and do that, air quotes. But so that the earthquake waves coming up, which would normally knock a building over, would be deflected away from that area and therefore minimise the impact on the building.
Have we been able to use any of that type of technology in modern times, with modern construction?
Well, this
or at least interpreted into a modern context?
This has only been discovered recently. So, this engineering firm was doing these experiments only about 5 or so years back. So certainly it's something they're working on. But the other thing which has come out of this research is that it seems that forests, if they're the right sort of forest, you know, trees at the right spacing and so forth, they might also be able to mitigate the effects of earthquakes. So some of this is fairly new. It doesn't mean we're going to have a forest in every city, but it does mean that we have a better understanding of how we how the waves, we know how the waves propagate, but a better understanding of how we can modify the way the waves propagate so they can minimise the effect on buildings and other structures.
All right, invisibility, not how we thought we would end up, but a way that the Romans were able to at least keep their buildings invisible too.
And it goes to show what a lot of trial and error can do for you.
Absolutely, do it till it stops working. As always, we love him. He is our Professor of Maths and Science, John O'Connor, joining us this morning on 2NURFM 103.7.